Hi, in this video, we are going to learn about the basics of Linux, which we will be using in this class to write all our programs. So this document is there in your shell, and I'm just using this so we can be aligned and we can use the same document. So go ahead and read through some of these things to find out what Linux is all about. It's an operating system, just like Windows, the Mac OS. So just read through it. It will help you understand why we are working on that. I will start with this how to log in part of it and how to use the server we have at PCC. So PCC has Linux servers, and you have access to that if you're taking this class. And this first video will show you how to log in, how to change your password, and how to do a couple of basic things. Okay. So the first thing you need to do is download PuTTY. So if you click on this link, it will take you and ask you to download PuTTY. And you can, depending on what system you have, you can click on one of these. It's really a quick download. And it downloads it. You can get some of the alternate files from here. And it installs it. And once it's done, you go down and tell it to start PuTTY. Okay, so type in PuTTY. It should be installed on your system. And you click. And this is what comes up. Okay, now this is where we need to start working on what are we going to put in here and how do we get our server to work. So if you notice, I have a couple of saved sessions here, and this shows you some of those things as well. And what you need to do is go down here, and this is the name of the server that you need to put in. So if you go under hostname, you can put in the name of the server, and you can save the session. Okay, that way every time you don't have to go and keep putting in the name of the server. So I have this called GD session. You put in the information, put port 22, make sure SSH is selected, which is by default. And you can always type a name in here, call it, you know, PCC server or whatever you want, and you save it and it creates it. And as you can see, I have a whole bunch of them. I can click on this and delete it. It's all the same stuff that it points to. And once you have it, you double click on it, or you click and say open, and that should open the server. And the first time you do get a warning telling you, you know, asking if you want to trust, make sure you read through it and you accept it. Now, if you're on the Mac, I'm looking here at this document. I can keep this window open here. Maybe you should log in a minute. We'll do that. So if you are on a Mac, if you notice here, open the Finder, navigate to Applications, open up the terminal, right? Open up your terminal, and you want to type in your MyPCC login name, which is, you know, if it's gd.iyer or Stephanie.allen, Shali.sengupta, whatever it is, you type in that, and then at syccuxas01.pcc.edu, and then it will ask you for the password. Then you type in your password, which is usually your G number or whatever you have set it to. It's usually the G number, the G, capital G, followed by the rest of the numbers, okay? And if you still can, you know, remember your password, then send a note to your instructor who can reset your password for you. So here I am at PuTTY trying to log in. So put in my first name, last name. And then notice as I type in the password, nothing shows up on the console. You won't see anything. Just keep typing and hit enter. If you make a mistake, then you might have to close this and then restart PuTTY and connect again. Okay. So now I'm connected to the server. Notice it has my directory folder name, and this is my home directory. Just like this picture shows down here, if you are connected, then this is how it looks. Okay, and that's with your name, and it should show you something. So if you can't get this part to work, or if you have problems with your password, please do send a note to your instructor, and they should be able to fix it for you. Once you have that, make sure your terminal is set to BT100. You can do that by just typing that. Now, if you want to change your password, you just type in password at the command line, and it should ask you for your old password, and then you can reset it to your new password. So if an instructor set your password to, you know, I don't know, banana or something like that, or your G number, and you don't want that to be your password, or you can't remember your G number, you just type in password, and it will ask you to change it. Okay. So here are some rules for selecting good passwords. Make sure you select a good password, something that you can remember, don't forget. And if you do forget, then you have to email your instructor who can change it. Okay, so that is the basics of getting logged in. Now let's do a few things by creating directories, right? So when you are, it's just like your any other operating system, you want to make sure you have things organized, okay? So this is going through, create some folders, create some files, we'll start with the basics. So I want to make dir. So all of this is typed at the command line, right? So here is make, mkdir says make a directory, and I will call it cs161b. Now case matters in Unix, in Linux. So Unix or Linux, those words are used interchangeably. Make dir mkdir cs161b. So make sure if you want to keep it all uppercase, or maybe you keep your folders uppercase, your files lowercase, come up with some kind of consistent plan, right? So mkdir, if you don't see any error messages, then you have it. You type in ll, or as this says here at the bottom, ls minus l will show you all the files with the permissions and everything. And I have a whole bunch of them, so it's kind of hard to see what it created. Here is another way to check it. I'm going to clears the whole thing. You can say ll and then type in cs asterisk, because I know I created my folder with a cs in front of it. And so it says where is cs161b, and there's a chapter 8. Let's try this, ls minus l cs asterisk. Okay, so it shows the same thing. It says total zero. That means there is nothing in there as far as that folder goes. And there is another folder here that has, that's called chapter 8 or something like that. Okay, so now how do I change to that folder? Cd says change directory 161b. Now I'm in that folder. Okay, and then anytime you want to see where you are, type in pwd. It says, okay, this is my whole folder. If you want to, you know, or whatever reason you want to send somebody some files, you want to know where you are, what the path is, then that's what it is. Now, how do you remove things? You want to remove a folder. Let's say I go, if you want to, right now there's nothing in here, total zero, right? I don't have any of the files. But let's say, oh, I created it. I wanted it all lowercase. How do you go up one folder? Cd dot dot will take you up one folder, okay? Now, if you want to remove this folder, rmdir to remove a folder. CS, and I can type in asterisk. Be very careful with the asterisk. It will remove everything with the CS in front of it. So I'm not even sure because I have a whole bunch of other folders. I may not want to do that. So remove rmdir 161b will get rid of it. Okay. So that's kind of how you make folders. Now, before we move on to the next one, let me create some more folders and do show a couple of other things. Make dir cs161b. I make the folder again. I change to cs161b. Now let's say I want to make some files, right? Clear will clear the screen, right? Just type in clear. Let's say I create a new file. There are a couple of different ways to create a file. Touch will make a file. You can say touch sample.txt. Right? And then if you do ll, it says, oh, look, there is a file called sample.txt. And I use vi to edit it. Let's just edit it, vi sample.txt. Or you can use nano as well. Nano is a little easier. If you want to use nano, we will do both in this class. Nano sample.txt. And then you just start typing. This is a sample file. That's it. I'm not going to put much in here. It's just a text file, right? And notice at the bottom, nano has a whole bunch of things that you can use to save. Control O says write out. So control O, it says, is this the name you want to give it? So just hit enter. Yep. And then control X will quit out of nano. And then here I am. Okay, now my file has something in it. Now I want to, let's say you can type in more sample.txt. We'll show you what's in the file. More says, show me what's in there. Now, if I want to go up one folder, and let's say I want to remove this folder. So dot dot also takes me up a folder. Okay, now I have this folder. Now if I type in rmdir cs161b, it's gonna say it's not empty, you can't remove it. Okay, so which is what leads us to this. Notice the document here. I'm looking at this document down here that takes rmprojx, right? Rm minus r. Anything in there. So if you said, well, you know, I really don't want this as a test folder, it has a whole bunch of garbage in it, remove rm, don't do rmdir, rm minus r. There is a difference between small r and big r, lowercase r and capital R, but 161b Well, now force it to remove it, right? It's all gone. So if I do llcs asterisk, I do have something else. I don't have any cs161b. It's gone. Okay, so that's the first part of this. That's the first part for our Linux videos. So we've seen how to log in, how to change password, and how to make directories, and how to make a quick file, and how to delete directories. Okay, we'll move on to the next part where we'll create files.